ಪಿತಾಹಮಸ್ಯ ಜಗತಃ ಮಾತಾ ಧಾತಾ ಪಿತಾಮಹಃ ವೇದ್ಯಂ ಪವಿತ್ರಂ ಓಂಕಾರಃ ಋಕ್ಸಾಮ ಯಜುರೇವಚ. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ಸಚ್ ಶ್ಲೋಕಾಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ talks in the first person. I am like this. I am in this form. I am in this presentation. I am in this manifestation. That is how he goes on projecting him in the varied form of this world, visible and invisible to us. Ishvara sarva bhutanam hrudyeshi arjuna tishtati brahmayan sarva bhutani indrarudhani mayaya. Somewhere he says, great Ishvara, he will be there behind this wonderful, ever-vibrating world, Jagat, Gacchati Jagat, ever-vibrating, ever-marching ahead, ever-moving further. That is why this world is called Jagat, Gacchati Iti Jagat. But if there is no something vibrating, something motivating behind it, how this inanimate, passive, dormant world can move? Not possible. So he is there, just like Yantra Arudhani Mayaya. I am there as a driver. So I drive so that I make this whole Jagat Gacchati, ever vibrating, ever moving, ever marching. So I am Ishvara. That's what Bhagavan says. I am there in the heart of everyone. Ishvara sarva bhutanam hrudyeshi Arjuna tishthati bhavayan sarva bhutan. So he makes this whole world moving ahead. That is what he says. Mayi sarva vidam krotam sutre manigana. Somewhere he says, I am like a thread, which joins all those different flowers coming from different origins, coming from different ingredients, different qualities, different qualifications, different fragrance, different forms, norms, performs. All those flowers, they come together. So I am there to play a role of thread, so that thread makes this wonderful God and this wonderful universe. Mayi sarvavidam prothama, intertwined, joined together. Sutre manigana, all those gems were made. They were put together so that Godland is there. What is that Godland? This ever moving, ever beautiful Jagat. I am there. This is my role. That is how I am. Like that he goes on presenting himself in various shlokas, many shlokas. So in this vibhuti he says, I am father, I am mother, I am grandfather. Pita hamasya jagata, mata thata, I am there to organize, I am there to hold everything together. I am the administrator, I am the organizer, I am father, I am mother, I am grandfather. That is how he goes on presenting himself. Today we have to remember that role of Bhagavan, where he plays the role of a thread which makes that wonderful God and Jagat. Yesterday or day before yesterday we celebrated. What is it? Parisara Day. Environment. So on 5th it was World Environmental Day. On 8th June it is World Oceans Day. Oceans Day. Today we are sitting here. So on 5th it was Environmental Day, on 8th it is Ocean Day. This wonderful world we have to envision, we have to imagine. Wonderful it is. It is created by Bhagavan. He is father of all this. He is mother of this world. He is the man. He is the organizer. So, whatever we see, it is some sort of manifestation, expression of that great universal Bhagavan divinity. With this divine feeling, if we celebrate any day, it will have its own special spiritual significance. Otherwise, mere merrymaking type of celebration, everywhere it is going on. What is there? People do some formal program. And some guest will be there. It will be just like normal Shraddha Vidhi. It is told in our tradition, Shraddha Vidhi. What is it? Shraddha Vidhi means somehow it is celebrated without knowing its meaning. So this is Shraddha Vidhi type of programs are going on everywhere. So it is Parisara Day, it is Mother's Day, it is Father's Day, it is this day, that day. While organizing all those days with that much significance attached to that, we must have that spiritual understanding. It must be backed with that understanding, not something mundane, something material, something outer, superficial, apparent something. So we must go to that inherent core of every action. With that understanding, if we celebrate, organize the program, it will have its own speciality and it will inspire people. So this Parisara Day or Ocean Day, all these things we must have, this meaning, this background we must have there. That divine touch must be given to every activity, every celebration must be spiritually rooted, spiritually oriented, spiritually suffused. Then only it will have its own significance. We at least yoga people, students and professors of yoga university must have this insight. With this insight only we have to organize all these things. Otherwise people come and plant, and there will be no person to even water. On the next day only there will be no person to take care of that plant. So Parisara Day is celebrated. Big news printed in the daily papers. Photos are there. Publications will be there. Propaganda will be there. Everything will be there. But that plant will be drained. No body to take care of that. This type type of superficial celebrations and organizations. Formal, too formal it is. In our system it is not like that. See, our forefathers, they used to have Nitya Dharma. Nitya Dharma. What is Nitya Dharma? It is Sandhya Vandana. It is Agni Hotram or Agni Karyam. It is Vaishwadevam. All these are daily programs. Nitya. Whatever activities they used to conduct, they were categorized under Nitya, Naimittika, Kamya and Prayashchitta. Four types of activities. Every householder, or whether he is a householder or a bachelor or an old vanaprasthi or great auspicious personality like great sannyasi, all they have all this. But sannyasis means they never have more and more kamya. But all other grihasthas, they will be having more kamya. Kamya means any action aimed at some expected result. It is kamya. Nitya is that which is daily performed. Getting up early in the morning, nitya karma. Chanting Bhagavad Gita or the Vedas, it is nitya karma. Planting, or it is watering those plants around our house, tulsi, bilva, all those flowers, creepers, trees, we have to water, we have to sprinkle water, that is after Nitya Karma. If we have cows, we have to take care of them, it is Nitya Karma. So these are Nitya Karma, they are not something special, Naimittika big celebrations. Naimittika are big celebrations, okay. For example, every day we don't go for our convocation program. Once in a year it is celebrated on 12th January. Oh, it is big program. Okay, you can go for something showy program, something formal. Okay, it is good. But this sense, nitya sense, that sense of eternity, it is very important. So that these celebrations of Ocean Day or celebrations of Parisara Day, environment, they are not some special Naimittika programs, formal, they are Nitya programs. Every citizen must have that duty to perform this. If there is plant tulsi, we have to water. Early in the morning, we get up and we have to do that. This is not something special every day. So when you perform Vaidyagni Mudra, then there will be auspicious ash collected in your vessel. That particular ash will have its own special antiseptic content in it. So that if just you put some quantity of bhasma ashes there, tulsi will have its own natural growth. So that is a. So every day you are getting up early in the morning, you are just taking care of those plants, performing Sandhya Vandanam so that you are sprinkling water, pouring water, doing Agni Karya so that you are doing, collecting those very medicinal ashes. Because you will be offering that pure ghee of original Indian cow breed. That will have its own special scientific significance, it will have its own medical value, medicinal value. So all these things are part of daily programs. They are not some formal, naimittika, occasional. No. Distance is very important. However, at least in a day, the whole year, we remember that we are part of this great, wonderful creation of which Bhagavan himself is father, he is the mother, he is the great grandfather. That type of family is this world. Here any plant or any cow or any species, they are all my co-travelers, co-commuters. I am with them, they are with me. This sense, if it is there, our Parisara Day celebration, our Environment Day celebration, our ocean, it will be wonderful. If we just see the whole scenario, Indian, on the bank of the shore, seashore, the bank of rivers, people are highly polluted people. Their mind is polluted, so they pollute water, they pollute everything. So if we just visit those seashores of India, Bharat, and our areas around many great divine rivers, Godavari, Ganga, Jamuna, what is that scene? People are so dirty, they are ugly, they pollute that water. This is our condition. This is Jagat Guru, great Rashtra, but people are so low. Philosophy is so high, practice is so low. Somewhere it is short-circuited. We have to make it correct. By yoga only we can do. For that Bhagavan gives wonderful margadarshana, guidelines. This is Pita Namaste Jagatah, Mata Dhata Pitamaha. So with this sense, this is the real expression of that divinity. It is around us. This is my parisara. This is my environment. This is my ambience. It is to be nourished by me only. With this sense, if we do all these things, or any program, or any performance, it will have its own special meaning. Om.